What's up, everybody? I'm Greg Miller, and believe it or not, it's been nearly 3 years since on a conversation with Colin, I showed you how to cook chicken wings at home in your oven. And I'll tell you what, we did the video, it was fun, I was excited to show it to you, but I couldn't believe the number of you that followed up on it, did it. I still, to this day, get tweets of the photos of the wings you guys made in your oven and at your home, super excited about them. But the problem is, literally when we filmed that episode, I started to evolve the recipe because Nick said something very, you know, Nick's stupid, of course. But in the episode, Nick said, you know, if you want them to be crispy, why don't you just put them right on the pan? I was like, that's a great idea. And I started doing that. And then I changed my batter. And then I changed a lot of how I did it. So I thought I would show you how to do it once again. A brand new thing here. If you haven't known, I got this kitchen island because my beautiful girlfriend Christine got it for me. But more importantly, I found a passion for cooking. It's something that built over 2015 and now has spilled into a full-blown love affair. So, everything I have here and the chicken I have over there is gonna be used to make our new wings. So what I like to do first is I start with making my new batter. Now, you say batter, you think I'm gonna drop them into a fryer. Now here's what I always say too. People are always up your butt when you talk about how much you love chicken wings, or at least me. And that chicken wings are bad, I'm gonna have a heart attack, da da da. Now, I'm no doctor, but I don't think chicken wings are that bad for you if you don't fry them. I don't fry my wings, and this was one of the things, right, is that I didn't want to fry or I didn't want the smell, I didn't want all these different things. So, what I had started doing is baking them with this recipe, and then I remember Dave Toole from IGN, who's a wing connoisseur like myself, gave me a lot of crap about that. He said I was making crappy wings that way. And so what I did is I started mixing my batters and changing around to get them crunchy. So right now, I do believe I make a wing that is crunchy and consistent, like fried, but not fried, if that makes sense. But they are breaded, which some people don't like, so whatever. First off, what I do, you won't need your measuring cup. It is one cup. I jump in, I get one cup of flour. Now, you could get away with less flour. I don't do it because it seems like there's always that off thing where I run out at the very end and I'm pissed off about it. You know what I mean? And then I gotta remix it. It doesn't get the right consistency and all this stuff. These are panko breadcrumbs. I like these Ian's ones. There's a million kinds. I like the breadcrumbs more than the flour for their crunchy consistency. So I give it a heaping cup. I do that. And I say, you know what, there's not that much left, and I just do that, because who the hell cares? You want it to be crunchy, you want it to be delicious. Now, the panko, of course, is probably the new addition, at least from what you remember in the old one, because in the old days, it was just flour, which was good, and it worked well. But like I said, the panko gives it the crunch I like. So I have that mixed up there. I won't need the measuring cup anymore. Similar ingredients as far as spices from last time. Cayenne pepper, as Colin said, I believe, in the conversation with Colin, seasoned to taste. I like putting a lot in there. I like that kick. Of course, I'm just gonna dump buffalo sauce on it anyway, so it really doesn't matter. Do that. Come over here with your black pepper. Put it in. You're just doing this till you like the looks of it. You may want more, you may want less. Sometimes I know I've had guests over when I'll cook them. I'll make them too hot because of too much pepper, too cayenne pepper. This, of course, granulated garlic here. I like to put a lot in there. Do that. Close that down. Those guys are done. And I just take a big fork, one of those big forks. You just want to mix it up there. Now, the thing about making wings at home is, there's no wrong way to do it. You get in there, you have some fun, you mix it up the way you want to mix it up, and guess what? Bam, you got chicken wings going, and everybody's in your house is happy. Because who isn't happy when chicken wings get made? Now, like I said, I prefer to toss mine in a buffalo sauce. Now, I set my buffalo sauce up, which I'll do for you here, and I'll also show you a few quick ways to get around not having a sauce that says buffalo on it. But you can, what I do for Christine, who doesn't like the buffalo stuff, is that I'll not sauce hers and then give her a thing of barbecue, and she'll toss barbecue on there, but she'll dip them. So she's not even ringing them up, if you will. She's just getting in there and doing it. So that's mixed to my specifications. You got to go in there. You can see the pepper flakes on top. Maybe if I was by myself and I was looking, you know, kick it up a notch, as Emeril Lagasse would say, bam, I put more cayenne in there, but I'm not going to do it. I have a whole bunch of people here who might not want that. Clear these guys off because I don't need them no more. Slide them over here, your spices. I like to keep it very clean as I go. This is one of the best parts about cooking. When you cook, people are impressed that you're cooking. And so you can just sit in the kitchen by yourself and get drunk. I highly recommend it. So now, I'm a garlic fiend. I don't know about you. So this is an optional step for you. But I like garlic. I like fresh pressed garlic. I like garlic and everything. And this is something I would have never thought of back in the day. First off, you take the garlic off the cloth. I'm gonna do three for the amount of wings I'm gonna make. I'm making, by the way, I should tell you that too. We'll get to it in a second. But right now I'm making what? Just about 2 pounds, a little bit less. You can scale this recipe. Like, you can mix it as much as you want, more as you want. Again, when it's seasoned to taste, equal parts breadcrumbs, equal part flour. Scale it however you want. Put as much spice as you want. But I like using the garlic. Now, this is something I learned from Christine's Aunt Ray. So shout out to Aunt Ray, living down in LA, you smash the garlic like that so you can peel it off real quick. Because for a long time, I'd sit there and I'd pick at the garlic and do, oh man, how am I gonna get off the skin? This is a pain in the butt. You smash it like that, not hard enough, see, it's not even smashed. You can peel the paper right off it. And yes, I call it paper, because God wrapped them up individually, each one of these cloves. Squeeze them off into this guy. I do this every time. You could wait. I don't like to let it build up. Do this. Now this is gonna, you might be saying, what's this wing, or what's this garlic? Where is it gonna play into the wings? It's gonna play into the wing sauce. I'm just doing this right now because I'm gonna sully this board with raw chicken soon. I'm gonna sully this knife with raw chicken soon. So, figure I'll get this out of the way. Put it in its little serving dish. Then I'll get a little bit of the garlic goodness on the wings when I cut them up. Something else different that I think I did, because last time we did this, I don't believe I did full chicken wings. What I did was just the drummies. I'm a big drummy fan. But I've come to the conclusion that I might be in the minority. Let me know in the comments below if you like drummies or the flats of wings. Because it turns out, like, Colin, Steimer, they both like the flats. I didn't expect that out of them. I expected better, but that's what I get. Huh?
What do I like?
The flats.
The flats.
So you got the little drumsticks, and then you got the two bones.
Oh, I like the flats.
You like the flats, yeah. He was ready to throw down on that, huh? Jeez. Put that aside. That's what I call them. I'm sure there's some scientific name for them, but I ain't no chicken doctor. Believe it or not, I don't have a chicken MD. I'm taking two eggs. Again, this is a different, you know, than what we did before. Because back in the day, I think we just tossed them in. In the original recipe we did in conversation with Colin, I took them, and what did I do? I did olive oil, I put them in salt, and then I did that. But now what I've done is I moved this egg mixture.
Help yourself with my eggs.
No problem. You don't want this company to be successful, is what you're saying? Are we not on a shared egg thing in the house?
Wow.
I had a carton in there.
I have no idea.
Then why are you busting my balls? I'm doing a cooking show over here, over there, yelling at me.
Each one of those eggs at Andronicus is like 75 cents.
We can afford it. Look at all this money we're getting on patreon.com/kindoffunny. Animated series. Thanks for your help.
Egg fun.
Yeah. Egg fun. Yeah, you thought you were supporting an animated show. You're really supporting our egg addiction. Toss that guy out of my way over here. This guy's done with tossing him out of the way over there. You're done with tossing out of the way over there. You guys are done too. Slide that up in there. Not up in there, just off to the side. So now what you can see is I'm assembling, of course, egg bath. I'm gonna cut up the wings, dip them in this, put them onto my tray. Before that, of course, need to get into these wings. Now, this is something you might laugh at me about, I'm sure. Like I said, I found my passion for cooking. But I would say, early last year, maybe a year and a half ago, if I'm being generous with time, I discovered you're not supposed to cut. Not, I didn't discover this in a bad way. Someone just told me when they saw me cutting raw chicken on a wood board, don't do that. Use a plastic one. And I was like, oh, I didn't know that. It'll seep into the wood. Yeah, well, I, you know, you don't think about it because you're gonna wash it in hot water, but the wood's just so porous.
Yeah, the problem is you have to put it in the dishwasher.
Yeah. Yeah, you don't do that. I didn't know that. So now look at me now. I'm cutting it on this one and I'm spreading the information, Nick, to people out there in the internet land. Now, Nick, I'm gonna need you again for a close up here.
Okay.
Cause this, again, I've gone the full, I'll see people put up like, you know who, what? I saw, kind of funny best friend, the Arctic Sloth, Frank Sizemore, make my old recipe for wings not too long ago. And he just took the wings, and not that you can't do this, took them out, they were in the three pieces technically, took them out like this, and just breaded them that way and tossed them in the oven. Now I've seen that, but of course I like to make it like a real wing restaurant and cut them up. And so I know some people scoff at that, they don't know how to do it. And the thing you do with it is you just power through. You just go there, you get a nice angle on it, and you just go right through it. Done, and you feel like, man, look at me. I'm making the dreams happen. Now I know Nick's saying he's not getting a good shot of it. Because I got beer in the way, I got this. But I just started at an awkward angle, so hold on. Glad everything over here. Huh? Nick. Yeah, I know Nick. I said, hold on. This guy, you know what I mean? Scrappy Do Scarpino, producer/seducer. Remember when you were going to film school, Nick?
Yeah.
Look at this.
What a
did you ever think you'd be doing this?
Yep. I kind of knew it would be that.
You knew you were building to this. A cooking show with Greg Miller, as demanded by his Chicken Island. Time to start preheating the oven. Bake. 435 is where you're going. Ding, ding, done. That'll go. We're gonna do, it's 20 minutes at 435. Take them out, flip them, 20 minutes at 445. You probably don't have to really up it that much, but I do it, because I'm crazy. So that's done over there. Come over here now. Now, I think this is still the original pizza pan I talked about in the original one. Colin, you remember from original conversation with Colin, did I use this guy? stolen from Gumby's in Columbia, Missouri years ago.
I never use that one. I always use the darker one.
I like this one because I can space them out more. Sure. You know what I mean? Because you don't want everything right on top of each other. It doesn't cook as well. I'm using this fancy-ass grapeseed spray oil that comes out in a weird... Watch this. Look at that. It's crazy, right? Comes out all crazy.
Square.
Yeah, you know? You know? Obviously, you could use Pam. You could use whatever. But I'll tell you right now, whatever you use, layer this shit on there. Holy cow. This is... I talk about how this recipe has evolved, right? From when you last saw it here on youtube.com/kindoffunny. But even that, this is probably the thing I'm still experimenting with, is the best way to put them on here and not have them on the second flip. Well, I flip them the first time, put them down, when I flip them and I pull them off, sometimes the chicken sticks and it drives me crazy. And I've been trying to do different things. I did one batch, right, where I flipped them real quick into the egg, bring it up, rip off the excess into this. Sure, you got plenty of chicken wings. Anyways, though, I put them in here, right? And this, usually I've sprayed it well enough where it's not a big deal. I like to push it back on there. Pack it back on there. Over here. You're not gonna change it. You just pat them in. And I like to get as much stuck to it as possible because again, I like the crunchies. I like the crunchy chicken wings. In fact, what you'll see maybe upon eating.
That shot around the corner.
What I see upon eating is after I've tossed them in the sauce and I have a bunch of crunchies left in the bowl, I take tortillas, flour, and then go in there and just dip in there and eat the buffalo sauce and the crunchies on the tortilla. Still in there with the close-up? See what I'm doing? I flip them, and I like to pack it in like that. Now, this will give you weird fingers. Your fingers are going to continue to get weird. You just got to suck this up. I know my fingers, I always say, are my most attractive feature, so it's hard for me to see them on the ropes like this. You know what I mean? But you got to do. I wasn't asking you, Nick. I'm asking the viewer. Nick, just stop. You stop responding. You understand what I'm saying? Good job, Nick. That one was directed at you. You could keep going. Anyways, so I'm still... What is going to happen is these will cook fine, probably not stick. But then, I'll flip them, take them out at the end of the 40 minutes, look at them, and they'll stick to the pan. And so what I had done actually on a recent try was when I was going to flip them, put them on a plate, sprayed it again, did it again, same fucking result. So I'm struggling with that part. I thought maybe for this one, what I would do is on the flip, put parchment paper down. Flip them back, go that way. But my problem is then I feel like I'm getting back to the tin foil where I was like, well, I like them crunchy. I like them well done. You know what I mean? I want them to crunch when you bite into them. I don't want them to lose that secondary heat. And then I was like, well, I definitely can't do it on this video. Because if I do it on this video and it comes out badly, you're all going to be like, why would I listen to this fake-ass broke Rachel Ray? Now, this isn't a Rachel Ray recipe, as I've said. I don't think I said that, actually. But it's one I found on the internet years ago. And I've continued to evolve, just like you can. That's the best thing about cooking. Like I was saying earlier, you get in there, you don't like an ingredient they're putting in there, put your own ingredient in. It's great. It doesn't matter. I hate onions. I keep them out of everything. So this one thing I make, this cauliflower, calls for pumpkin seeds. I use almonds. I like pumpkin seeds. It's just harder to find. My thought was, because you know me now with this cooking thing, I like it. I put these challenges in my head. My thought on what I was going to do, so like I said, 435. 20 minutes. I go top rack because I want them to get nice and crunchy. My guy's a little bit too big. Put him in there. Do that. And then 20 minutes on the clock. Start. See, that means 20 minutes have passed and it's time to take the wings out and flip them around. So turn off your timer and then while you're here, take it up to 445. Again, to make them nice and crispy. Now you hear that sizzle. That's the sound of chicken wings. There you go, Nick. Get right in there. You like those, Nick? You like what you're seeing, Nick? Yeah, I like what I'm seeing. So you put them down there. Be very careful. Use oven mitts. If you can find one that has Fran Mirabella's face on it, I highly recommend it. This is a gift from Mark Nix, though. So what you're doing here, you can already see that they're getting nice and brown. They're starting to go where you want them to go. Is you want to flip them now. But I like to move them around a little bit like that. And like, this is what I was talking about earlier, right? Is like, these ones are giving me a bit more trouble already, which I'm not a huge fan of. I tore that one. Sorry, Mom. Flip this guy. There you go. So you're just gonna flip them. Like I said, if you, right now in the comments, have a solution for why, or how, I guess, not to make it stick, but still to make them crunchy, because that's the one thing. I don't mind the fact that I sacrifice, in terms of flipping them on the second flip, that I sacrifice maybe 3-4 wings out of a batch that like lose more skin than I'm comfortable with. If you have a suggestion that isn't just aluminum foil, would parchment paper still brown? Let me know. That's a big thing. Because look at this. You getting this, Nick?
Yeah.
I don't think you're fucking getting shit, Nick. I think you just lied to me. I can see the shot. See how nice and brown these guys are? I love that. I love brown guys.
Yeah, I got it.
I haven't moved the camera an inch. I love you guys. Remember when we worked jobs? Yeah. Just keep flipping them like that. I like to do a little spin before I do it. There you go. Spread them all out like that. Get them. You want that space in there. You get the space. The space between, as Dave Matthews once said, when I think he was talking about cooking chicken wings in your kitchen. Not the same song, but a good one. Remember when the Dave Matthews Band's tour bus dumped shit on people? Yeah. It was in Chicago. It was in the Chicago River. The best. You put him back in there. Timer on. 20 minutes. All right, so we're going to talk about buffalo sauce now. Now, if you notice what I have here is crystal buffalo sauce. Now, what, for a long time, here in San Francisco, Colin and I had to scrounge for buffalo sauces. And what it usually meant was getting Crystal or Frank's Red Hot. And I mean just straight up Crystal or Frank's Red Hot. There were none of the buffalo varieties. Because the buffalo variety is brought down a few notches because you need so much of it, the volume of it. Buffalo sauces, though, usually, you know, they're not like that. They're not as hot as the Frank's. Now, I haven't used the Crystal buffalo sauce in quite some time. So what I like to do is pour a bit out, then just get the smallest spoon in your drawer. Come on over. Do that. And just yeah. See, so the thing is, again, we're talking about buffalo sauces. God, it's good. Don't what? It's good.
That's like your weekly salt intake right there.
No. No. It's got zero everything and then a 19% sodium. So what? I just took 20% total. So good.
You're going to use another spoon, right?
I'm not going to use a spoon at all.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. So, it's not that hot. I'm going to be fine. Is anybody averse to hot things? Hot wings? No? What I do sometimes, if I'm using just a Frank's or just a Crystal, which have that extra kick to them, put them in there. And then this is where wings get unhealthy again. You put like 2 tablespoons of butter in there, mix it up, and it cuts it. Because of course, milk counteracts hot stuff, as you know from Hot Pepper Gaming. This one's not that bad. They're fine with it. What I'm going to do, move it to the stove. I put a little bit in there off the spoon. Not the part I tasted. Drop the garlic in, get that heated up. Because I like garlic on my wing. So what I would do, just take that, toss it in there, put it over there, spin it around, get it hot, then toss as much sauce as you want. I use a lot. Spin them around, put as much sauce as you want, and then we'll come back. We'll pull them out in 15 minutes because they'll be done. We'll do that. Then we'll pull them out, and we'll toss them. You'll see how I toss them. And there you go. Another 20 minutes done. Timer off. Nobody wants that crap off that. Turn off the bake and pull these wings out. Oh, good Lord. Now, Nicholas, give me this. Now, see what I'm talking about? Crispier. More crunchies on them than we had before. That was very important to us, remember? I'm talking about from the old recipe. And thank you to somebody who already on Twitter, sorry, I don't remember your name right now, told us that I should be using a wire rack. That would help them not stick on the second part. This one's not, so that's good. Some people wait. Those are skinny people. Maybe they let them cool down a bit. Not my MO. I just get right in there, start pulling them up. Because I want them now. Maybe, you know, I'd have a different thing. But here's the thing. You can already hear them. Listen to them drop in there and like the crunchies. See, this is one of the ones I was talking about. It's going to be a bitch. Still that noise, that crunch noise. Like, did you hear that one right there? Did you hear that crunch noise? What is this? You want me to, I don't want to, like, see, some of them come right off. But listen to this guy. You ready? You like, see what I'm talking about? They got a shell. That sounds less appetizing than when I'm like crunchies and they do what I want them to do. See, there's the other one. Yeah, I lost that guy. He's a loser. Don't worry about him. Yeah, that one came off. This is pretty, we're getting a pretty good batch here. Oh, look at that guy right off. Done. Done. Perfect. So we got them. As I told you earlier, get your sauce going on another one over here. Have it set up the way you want. I mixed in the garlic. So this guy's already set to go. I was gonna move this, change my mind. You're allowed to do that. I should have given this guy a beat around, but whatever. I'm like that. I'm like, I'm just gonna dump it all in there. You know what I mean, Nick? Sometimes, if I'm feeling crazy, I'll go in there and do the one pass, like half of it, because then you do this deal. Remember, back in the old conversation with Colin, Colin made fun of me for putting my hand over it like this. And he's like, I've never had a wing jump out when I shake my wings. And I'm like, I have. And since then, even with this method, I've had it. Because you need to get up in there. You need to do this. You need to get, like, centrifugal force. I think it was Sir Isaac Newton who found that one. You get it going that way. So they're circling around like that. And then even then, like, you know, here's the funny thing. I'm not happy with the sauce coverage on that. Now, thankfully, this is a brand new bottle of sauce. It wasn't chilled before, so it doesn't matter. Do that, do that, do that, do that. I should have saved the sauce. There you go. Like I said, you learn something when you cook. I should have known my original thought. It's a good point. You probably shouldn't have ate so much of it. It's like when you're making cookies, but you eat all the cookie dough. That's what happens when I drink all the wing sauce. There you go. We got a whole bunch of wings. Look at them there, Nick. Look at that coverage. You're gonna sit there and tell me that doesn't look good, Nick?
Gorgeous.
You gonna fucking lie to me?
Gorgeous.
All right, thank you. Serving is up to you. I have a whole bunch of hungry men over here, as I often do in my apartment. So what I'm gonna do is dump them into this cat ramen bowl from Japan that I like quite a bit. Here's the thing. If you work at Sur La Table right now, I wanna talk to you. Everybody else can, you know, zone out for a second. I went to Sur La Table and I'm like, you know what? I'm in. I'm into cooking. It's a thing. I want to buy a bunch of really, really nice shit. Added it all to my cart, Nick. You know what happened? Went to check out, and it's like, shipping details. Nothing pops up. It's a dead fucking part of the site. And so I couldn't order. And I was like, maybe it's just a nighttime thing. Next morning, I woke up, coffee, went in there, circle top, shipping details, blank. Then it pops up, and it's like, do you want help? Do you want to, you know, the chat help or whatever? I'm like, yeah, I want chat help. And the chat help pops up and it's like, what's the problem? And I'm like, shipping details is broken. And they're like, call this number. I was like, I don't want to order online. I don't want to talk to anybody.
Do you want to come to my, I have a shirt pop in my neighborhood.
I do want that actually. Can you give me a ride home?
Yeah.
Not tonight. Can we come back later?
We don't speak French.
Charles Tom. Eat one before you go and tell them how you like them.
It's too hot.
Well, just fucking talk to me for 10 seconds. No.
It's hot. It's
Kevin, no.
Talking to my chest and tell them how it is. They're nice and crunchy, right?
Ooh.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
No?
It's so crunchy.
Yeah. That's the thing that they were missing before. Before, my chicken wings weren't as crunchy.
10 out of 10.
Wow. So ladies and gentlemen, that's my wing recipe in 2016. I'm sure it will continue to evolve and I will continue to do videos every 3 years. Until then, however, please go to patreon.com/kindoffunny. Support us right now in January to try to get the Kind of Funny animated series off the ground. And if it's after January, please come there to support us after we got into crippling depression when we couldn't get the Kind of Funny the animated series off the ground. Until next time, it's been my pleasure to serve you. Now here's my question, Nick. I'm getting ready to toss these bad boys in. They'll cook for 20.
Okay.
Usually on the back half, the other 20, yeah. That's when I do my wing sauce stuff. Okay. Get that ready. However, you had mentioned during our live stream on twitch.tv/kindoffunnygames
yeah.
that you wanted me to try breading a taco.
Yeah.
Do you still want me to do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah. Soggy mess in the bag. Got it, everybody. You can't hear him, I'm sure. My thought was, because you know me now with this cooking thing, I like it. I put these challenges in my head. My thought on what I was going to do, what I was thinking I would do, is that I would take it and wrap it in another tortilla. Oh. Then use my cooking string to wrap it nice and tight, and then try it that way. But no, it's a congealed mess. I don't want to do it for you.
You want to look in it,
I don't. I don't want any of the things in there. Guaranteed.
There's the nachos in there we can try frying.
But you got the bad nachos. You didn't get the kid nachos that I like.
That's very true.
I like kid nachos, apparently. Back in my day, those were not a kid thing. They were just like the side.
You nachos? They're just nachos. I don't think they're on the kid.
Oh, okay. Well, you hurt my feelings. I'm tossing away the breading then. The little bit I have left. Unless you want me to try.
No, not for this.
I mean, we've got 20 minutes.
I'll look at it.
Sure, bring it over.
Yeah, no, these are just... Well, that's a chalupa.
So if you didn't know, if you weren't watching the stream, and I'm not sure how much Kevin's editing out for the YouTube video, we got a big old bag of Taco Bell and did an unboxing. And then Nick had the idea that he wanted me to try to cook one of these guys.
We can try this. That's okay. A good burrito right there.
Okay.
That could probably work.
Okay. I don't even know if I need to...
Probably don't need to rewrap.
No, we don't. Okay. You're right. Put him right there.
Thank you.
I mean, don't thank me. I don't know if it's going to come out for you. You got to try a bite of it, though.
I'll try a bite of it.
This is something fun when your friends buy too much Taco Bell. Try doing the chicken wing recipe to it. What's the worst that can happen? I'm going to get it ready. I don't think I'm going to put it in, though, till the 20 minutes.
Yeah, you don't need
And I'll flip it at 10.
Yeah, you don't need one.
And even then, it's going to be super well done.
Yeah. It's going to be crispy.
I mean, that's what you wanted.
Yeah.
I mean, what I'm basically doing is taking Taco Bell... In making a straight up, fuck, I was hoping, chimichanga, there it is. I knew I would get there in the end, but I wasn't ready when I launched out on it. I'm tired now, it's been a long day. James, it's been a long day. All right, as long as you know. Here's what we'll do.
Are we gonna cut this out of the normal video?
I don't know. It's definitely filling the Twitch stream though.
I'm gonna get a cup real quick, I'm on some Diet Coke.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah, well, in the regular video, you can come in.
I know, but this is like, you know.
This is the pilot for Cooking with Greg.
It looks good. It's a good looking pilot.
Team Fat. What do we call it? What was Cooking Team Fat? Team Fat Cooking? I don't know. Somebody had an idea.
We call it Our Drunk Kitchen.
Our Drunk Kitchen, right.
Yeah, word for
him. No, we were pretending like we didn't know that was a thing.
Oh, she's not a person?
No, we know she's a human being.
Was she like an animated puppet?
She is like an animated puppet.
Where do you think the word Muppet comes from?
Jim Henson.
But it's a puppet. Where'd the M come from? Man puppet.
Is that real? Is that a real Colin thing? I don't know. So we're gonna do it this way. We're gonna
etymology. That's your brother. You would know. See what he says. He's gonna say, "You know, good idea, Nick. I don't really know that."
Is he gonna say it like that?
Trademark September 26, 1972, claiming use from 1971.
Do you want close-ups?
Employed by creator Jim Henson, who said, despite the resemblance to marionette and puppet, they have qualities of both. It has no etymology. Just like the sound. Puppet. So the urban legend is that it's marionette and puppet.
Gotcha.
Isn't Muppet a term they use in the UK?
Horrible.
Hey, you know what? You shouldn't have left the stream, Kev.
What are you doing?
Nick wanted me to try to bread one of the burritos.
Yo, you can't eat that.
Why not?
No, he's gonna fry it.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm not. No one's eating. I'm putting it in the oven.
Yo, you can't eat that. I thought you were gonna put it in like a microwave.
No. This is going in the oven on the second 20-minute thing. Oh, everybody.
Yeah, we're gonna make it a chimichanga. Yeah, well, that's fine. Yeah, thank you for looking out for us, though. Like, sometimes I just eat random.
I don't trust Greg as far as like, I'm not important
to us. You asked me to cook for you last night! I mean, I would put it in the bowl if I had a bigger, deeper bowl. But that's always a problem. Finding a big, deep crevice is tough.
Kevin's got one.
You got a big, deep crevice?
You can use
Kevin's
bowl?
No, I don't want to make more dishes here. Now we're giving Epic Mealtime a run for their money. What do you think of that, Harley? Jack Daniel.
Perfect.
Kevin Smith put me in a film. So we're making this monstrosity here for Nick. You said you're gonna put buffalo sauce on it.
Yeah, you're gonna do the whole shebang. I want the whole.
Well, I'm not gonna toss it like I toss my other things.
No, just glaze it.
Oh, gotcha.
Do you have a glaze brush?
Yeah, I do. I'm Greg Miller. You saying I don't have a glaze brush? You think I'm playing? I got a kitchen island, son.
I liked yesterday when Colin was like, no way Greg needs every single one of these measuring. There's like 5 million.
Yeah, I was putting it on the bingo. You used every, it wasn't only the measuring cups. It was the measuring teaspoon and tablespoon. 6 of them.
Yeah.
Impossible.
I get around.
You're the fucking frugal gourmet over there.
I didn't touch kids.
Yeah. I forgot about that.
Right?
We had the same conversation.
This entire conversation has happened on a conversation with Colin. With you chiming in the same way.
I would have never known that about the Super Bowl.
Poor guy. All right. Getting that going, doing this thing here. Now, I won't do it for the stream, of course. But if you're at home, what you should be doing in this downtime is clean the dishes you just made. Get them out of the way. Don't make them wait. Pain in the butt, you know?
I hate when people stack dishes up.
Yeah. I hate it when it happens and there's nothing you can do about it. Like when you and I are cycling in the kitchen, like we gotta get out of each other's way or whatever.
I wash yours and you wash mine. At
least it's how it works out. That's how it works out. The burrito is part of the Twitch experience, not the YouTube experience. If you're watching on YouTube, Nick forced me to take a Taco Bell burrito and bread it the exact same way. So I'm gonna put this in, and at 10 minutes, flip it, and then we're gonna put buffalo sauce on it, and I'm gonna plate it as my Lord and Savior, Rachel Ray, would. Or we're gonna flip your burrito. Now this is Twitch exclusive content.
Great.
Support us at patreon.com/kindoffunny. Oh, look at this guy, Nick. Look at him slide around. He knows what's up.
I'm telling you right now, that might be the new thing.
I'm so excited about that.
That might be the new thing?
Might be the new thing.
I didn't wash my tongs yet. They touched chicken that wasn't fully cooked, so I'm not gonna do this. Ooh. Ooh, Nick. I like the Nick.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Nick.
Oh, if I could zoom in more on that, I would, but I can't.
You want me to walk in into you?
No, you're gonna hurt yourself.
No, this probably hurt Colin.
Right.
Oh man, Nick, come get a whiff of it.
Right there is good. Yeah, that's good.
Nick, come get a whiff of this log.
Hold on. Let me smell it.
Tim, come smell this log from Taco Bell that I made and then suck it, Harley.
Oh my God.
New epic meal time.
What about that burrito?
The burrito is for the Twitch audience. We were finishing the YouTube video.
I think it's over here somewhere.
What do you want me to do now?
You wrap it up. Give me the shot of the product shot and wrap it up. Give me a strong outro here.
Now, I'm plating this for you, Nick. Because
okay.
I'm going to make you believe in Rachel Ray's skills. I already know. You already know I'm a good cook. Don't fucking be funny about it, you little bitch.
Your little bitch is definitely the wiser.
All right. So I've brought over the accoutrements, Nick. To really step my game up here.
Wow.
To impress you. Take the wings over there. Everybody eat some wings. James, eat a wing.
Thank you for the wings, Jerry. They look really good.
Thank you for being a good partner. All right.
Thank you to Nicole Tan.
Thank you to Nicole Tan if she's watching, which I'm sure she is. All right.
I'm not saying it's a bad thing.
You hear that crunch?
Think about it.
You're $90 away.
From what again? I'm telling you, I want you to know what Rachel Ray has taught me, how I believe in what I've learned here.
I have time for that, and we'll have fun. Yes, you know that. It's not happening today.
But I can look at when we've had fun together. You getting in there? You see what I'm doing here? Hold on.
Yeah, I'm with you to the end, like always. The angular cut is a beautiful touch.
You like that?
Yeah.
Again, this is the thing. These are the things I've learned.
Kevin, how much you want some of this?
Right now.
Yeah. You're gonna have one.
You're gonna have one too?
Oh, yeah. You're putting rosemary on it?
Yeah.
That doesn't make sense. Don't do that. You're killing
it.
Leave it.
It's just for visual purposes. Don't worry about what I'm doing over here, all right? Yeah, but, well, you know, whatever.
Yeah, Cotton Eye Twit says Rosemary Burrito, bro. Garnish game is sus, and I agree. You don't put things on the plate that you can't eat, even if it's for decoration.
You can eat that. You can eat all this. You can eat all that.
It doesn't make... You should have stopped.
Keep in mind that this isn't a burrito. This is Taco Bell. Some millionaire shit in a tube, and here it is for you to eat.
The consensus is you're overstuffed.
Yeah, I don't care. I'm out there having fun. This is too much. This is too much. Let me do this. There you go. Perfect. There you go. Nick, take that. Eat some of that. All
right.
Come over here. Eat it on stream. Let people know how it came out.
Kevin.
Kevin, come eat some too. Hold on. Let me take a photo.
I'm going to hold it. There you got it.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's a good looking picture.
Go.
Take one the other way too, just in case he wants to.
What? Portrait?
Rosemary and lemon garnish goes great with burritos. Definitely not seafood.
There you go.
All right, Kevin.
This seems like it's going to be too hot to
touch. Oh, get a fork. Or just pick it up. You don't like it at all?
No, I do.
I want there to be more sauce, though.
You can take some more out. I just didn't do whatever you want. There's, look at this. This is what I was talking about. For you at home with the Twitch, sorry. Jesus Christ. I left this out of the real video. You gotta get your tortilla out. Get your flour tortilla.
No, wait till Nick moves and we're still
This
rolling.
Is for the Twitch audience. No, it's fine. I said it in the other room. You're taking your tortilla like this. Huh?
There we go. On the tree. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Right? I think
so hot I can't taste anything.
I think I got a little lemon on mine, and it really brings out the flavor.
You know what
Thank you.
The flavor out, a little
Bunch of second. I'm sure all these fucking nerds. My the camera's off. My mic's off. I'm sure all these fucking nerds on Twitch who don't
you
know anything. I hate beans. I'm not eating that. But again, what I'm going to show you is you take this. You got all your crunchy bits in there. Do this.
Oh yeah, buddy. Or, give me the crunchy bits on there.
Okay.
Give me the crunchy bits.
Okay.
Half
Crunchy bits are on there. You okay, Kev?
Yeah, just while you're doing it.
Why'd you run in here like the fridge was on fire? Why'd you step on Porty's water dish?
While you guys were doing a close-up, I wanted to grow. I'm gonna edit all of this out.
No, you're not.
No,
this is
nice
gold. This is what. Keep following him, Nick. All I'm doing, everybody at home. dip them in the eggs. Nick, I need you on the camera fast. We got a sighting of a Kevin here. We got a Kevin Coelho. Oh, he got away. He's a shy little guy. They say if he comes out, he sees his shadow, someone's gonna die.
That was like an Abba.
That was like a Yeti.
Almonds, however, though, they fucking come out of the gutters. We've been talking all day, Nick. Did you know that?
You're the last of us to break.
They come out of the gutters. I'd love to live in that world. Colin, you like almonds?
Almonds.
Yeah? Would you eat them out of the gutter? If they were coming out naturally.
What's my state of desperation?
Walk.
They're coming out naturally.
Yeah, you're walking down to Arts. All of a sudden you look down, almonds coming out naturally. Kids are running around filling their pockets with almonds.
Are the almonds cracked already? If they're coming out of the ground, are they already,
They're shelled. Yeah, they're shelled. They're whole, though. They're not salted or roasted.
I like whole raw almonds.
Yeah, me too.
The problem with almonds is that they're going up exponentially in price.
That's why I think it's that really... If they're coming out of the gutters naturally, and FEMA's out there, and they're like, this shit's good to eat. Because someone
designating
Mayor Ed Lee called in FEMA when this.
You know what FEMA is?
Mayor Ed Lee in San Francisco is like, hey, fuck it, man. I don't know what I'm doing. Get a FEMA in here. We got to get them to look at these goddamn almonds. Too many almond problems up in this bitch. And just keep packing them in like that. See, my fingers are continuing to get bigger and grosser. I hate it, but it's what you do. You got to struggle through it, right, Nick? Keep on packing it in. Pack it in. Pack it in. Nick, how much you cook?
Not as much as I probably should.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's to say, I don't.
Does D cook?
Cooks even less. We prepare a lot. So I'll have like a salad and chicken on.
Sure, sure.
Maybe a steak. But for the most part, I claim to be too busy to cook.
But you are. You're doing a lot of work. We all do a lot of work.
Busier than I am.
For me, it's a relaxing hobby. You know what I mean? Like I said, I'm in here, I'm trying different things. Yeah. I'm praying to the altar of Rachel Ray. I'm cleaning off my filthy fingers.
Amazing.
Now, it's because you'll see, though, some of the chunks are falling off there on them. That is flavor country. Yeah. Those little guys right in there, everything falls off your finger. Whew.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
The crunchies, you call them, man.
You make me eat raw chicken. The egg is fine. I need the shit out of it. I just suck your finger.
I understand that.
If you were breading, steak, yeah, you could do that.
That's a good point.
But if you were breading, tofu or something.
Sure, sure.
Straight suck that shit right off of you.
Sure, that makes sense. I mean, I would love it, probably. If you can't hear, Colin's going to suck stuff off my fingers. Could you what?
I was going to say, you can probably... This is a fascinating recipe.
Yeah.
Really wrap this in anything, really.
Oh, sure. Well, this is the thing. Yesterday, I cooked this meal. But I'd wanted... There's a lot of things I miss from when we worked at IGN, right?
Yeah.
Chief among them, Merrigan's Sub Shop.
Oh, yeah.
Right across the street. You heard me talk about it on GameScoop all the time. Delicious chicken parms. And it's far enough to where I'm never going down to Merrigan's just for a chicken parm. And when I go down for Super Knockin' Boots, nobody wants to go eat at Merrigan's. They want to eat somewhere else. So, I broke down and tried to cook it myself, make my own chicken parm. Bought the chicken thighs, pounded them nice and thin, got them in there. I'd use this breading. I used this exact thing last night to bread the chicken and do it that way. And let me tell you, it was good, but it's another recipe now I have to learn and modernize. Pushing this into the little trash hole here. I mean, it's not going to be good, because I don't think any Taco Bell food thing that sat that long is going to be good, Nick, but it doesn't look bad. You know what I mean? Hey, Tim. Where are we at with like money and milestones and what do I need to be pitching and talking about? Because we got downtime.
My girlfriend just texted me. She said that Greg Miller's now my favorite member of Kind of Funny.
Thank you.
She likes it.
If you didn't hear that, Gia, Tim's girlfriend, says I'm her favorite member of Kind of Funny. Wait till I get my back waxed. Is she doing it?
You doing it?
Doing what?
Who's waxing my back?
I'll do it.
Can I do it?
So where are we at right now?
We are currently at 46,470.
Which puts us 330 off of the next goal? Oh, sorry. I thought I got... Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're 530 away. We now have 6,032 patrons total, which means we got 33 new ones in the last, 15 minutes.
Shout out to New Kids. Thank you so much for supporting this, which, of course, is supporting the animated series. What do you got for me, Nick?
A lot of comments about how disgusting the burrito is going to be.
Oh, yeah.
I think people are hating.
I mean, don't get me wrong. For your sake, I hope when we cut it, I'm going to plate it for you. I'm going to do everything in my power to make this thing look fucking awesome.
Thank you.
You're welcome. But it's going to be bad. But I'm going to make it look like fucking Rachel Ray came in here and was like, hey, Greg Miller, you're the newest associate editor at Rachel Ray every day. And I'd be like, really, Rachel?
No, fuck you. Keep subscribing.
No, you just keep making things I make and you don't make them as well.
You just keep putting garlic in everything.
I do. That's a trade secret, though.
Garlic?
Yeah.
Fresh garlic's great. No one knew about garlic until... Greg Miller brought that shit out.
Well, I'm just saying, people don't put it in enough things.
You can put it in almost
anything. Wings? Yeah. Eggs? Yeah. Yogurt? Yeah. I'm making something, garlic's in it.
Yogurt?
Yeah. Glass of water?
Portillo, that's enough.
Porty. Hey, shut up. Portillo, go to bed. Hold on, stop. We've never gotten this on camera, Colin. Get it on camera, I was sending him to bed.
All right, hold on. Portillo, go to bed.
No, not yet. He's not ready.
It's gonna take time.
I know.
Go to bed.
Oh, it's happening. Portillo, you are a bad dog. You go to bed. You are being Portillo. Bad. Go to bed.
Go to bed.
Try to get. Look at how slow he walks. Go to bed, you bad dog.
Go to bed.
He's bad.
Actually goes to bed.
Well, yeah, he knows. He knows what that is. He knows when he's bad to go to the bed until dad comes in there, takes off the belt,
yeah, he won't be out in 2 seconds.
And just fucking no. Don't do that. Don't hit your dogs with a belt. Your kids? Sure. They gotta learn. If they're gonna talk in the movie, I mean, here's my thing. I'm always like, don't smoke. Your kid talks in the movie, light it up right there, turn around and put... No, don't do that. Okay. Does everybody like garlic?
Nope.
I like garlic in my wings. Something I learned from Wing Wings in San Francisco. Oh, yeah. I like how you shake your head as you cross in the middle of the shot to go use a garbage can.
Why are you throwing beer in the garbage?
What? It's right here. The trash will never know. Trash man will never know.
Sort your life out.
You think Mayor Ed Lee's watching right now?
Yeah, I'm not sure Mayor Ed Lee's even a real person.
I don't know how to interact that information.
Oh, did we get the place right?
Mm-mm.
So where the hell are
they? I didn't want people looking in our kitchen thinking it was out of control, so I tossed them in there. I don't want people looking in the kitchen looking at us out of control. We got to. Why is everybody in here? I don't know. We were trying to make a professional video about wings. That you crossed right in front. You probably. Kevin, there's nothing to do. So you're saying I shouldn't just take spoonfuls of hot sauce?
Stop doing that. I'm worried about your blood pressure.
Salt doesn't affect that. Sodium doesn't affect that.
I'm not worried about it.
Yeah, Colin's not worried about it. They said he had high blood pressure.
My blood pressure is perfect, actually.
Really?
Yep. Cholesterol.
Oh, cholesterol. You're right. Sorry. I apologize. I'm defaming you on the internet.
That was 1 tablespoon.
Huh?
1 tablespoon. So that's like 2 tablespoons.
I did it twice.
You got 80% of all the salt.
Good. Come eat that on camera. Come right here and eat that. You can eat these guys? You don't eat bread.
Pizza's going good.
Go open and eat.
Maybe.
Check it on the burrito.
Is it smoking? Is that what all that black...
I mean, there's a lot of steam coming out. It's not black.
Oh, it's looking good.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Christine just texted me, you waxed your back. And I said going to. For all you Twitch watchers, let's do a second screen experience. I'm gonna take a photo, tweet it out. 3 minutes till I'm flipping that burrito. Get hype.
Excited about this. Real excited about it.
Kevin, turn their mics back on. Or his mic back on. Kevin, please. I didn't mean to order you wrong. We gotta get Mayor Ed Lee on this show.
Oh, I'd love that. He would totally come on. Nothing better to do.
It's on Nick.
Well, first off, I assure you he doesn't have anything better to do. Except ignoring all the problems Muni have. Am I right?
But you don't watch all of them right now?
Yeah, thank God.
Just the cups? Check in the comments and see how we're doing.
Yeah, let me know what they think. Have you guys ever eaten 2 giant spoons of hot sauce? It's fine.
I actually have.
You, no!
Not a spoonful, per se.
Speaking into it, thank you.
But I have, in a sitting, probably had the equivalent to 2 tablespoons.
Of course.
If not more. Because you have to figure, when they give you the side of the sauce, and you eat the whole thing.
Yeah. Same thing, yeah.
Same thing.
Ooh. Spencer on Twitter said, so game over, Greggy. This is the solution to Brennan sticking the spray with oil. And it's a little grape thing.
Oh.
Very smart. I have.
Yeah, but it's going to stick to the grape, too.
But not, I mean, there's not going to be as much surface area.
Then how are you going to scrape them up with the grape? I guess you can go
same thing. I take the guys and I rack them that way.
Right, that's a good call. Good job, Spencer. That's the brain on you. Where were you 8 years ago when we first started making this shit?
Dan Wilkinson on Twitter said in the middle of all of this, all at Kind of Funny Vids patrons, do you realize we pay our hard-earned money for this?
I think it's something that's just best left.
He's not wrong.
No, he's not. That's correct. I like being the Robin.
What? I like doing dumb stuff like this.
I do too. Does that make Colin Artie Lang?
Sure.
Okay.
Is Artie Lang dead? Or?
No, he just disappeared.
Oh, he disappeared.
He's just doing shows.
I mean, he's back now, but he was not for long. So much to say. So much
someone
to
died.
Say.
Oh, Greg Giraldo.
He did. Oh, right. Yeah, he is dead. Rest in peace.
I'm sure I actually know who Greg Giraldo is.
Nick, you want to get on the camera? Be careful, it's really hot, Tim. You're getting too close. Hold on, everybody get your head in the shot. There you go. Now, Kevin, you're really fucking close. I don't like that one bit. Why did Nick go zoom in on your crotch? That wasn't them smelling it at all.
Stop! I don't like this one bit. I'm screwing.
Nobody will believe you.
We have footage.
Yeah, but this is like Periscope. It just goes out and nobody ever knows what happens next. Kind of funny. Let us help us make this animated series. So much to say, so much.
What do you have Dave Matthews saying? Let's unwrap that.
We said something that was a Dave Matthews lyric.
Never a Dave Matthews fan.
Yeah.
I didn't know that about you, actually.
And in fact, not only that, but I find it insulting that there are legitimately Dave Matthews fans out there.
You know the first person who ever told me about Dave Matthews? My Uncle Scott.
Oh.
You liked him.
How would I I'm not speak
with a name like Scott?
How would I fucking know you didn't like them?
Is Mike number one on?
Kevin.
I need Mike number one because I got to tell you something.
Yeah.
It's really important.
Okay.
Because you and...
I'm wondering where that North Korea bomb
top. Oh, no. There's no North...
Hey, what mic do you have?
Three.
I mean,
thank you,
solid.
Kevin.
Can you hear it foul?
Kevin, did you hear that the North Koreans detonated a hydrogen bomb?
Oh.
Isn't that nice? The North Koreans detonated a hydrogen bomb today and caused an artificial earthquake. No, what I was going to tell you was that you already, you know, with Erin, you're already on our bad side because of the fries situation at Del Taco. But
Aaron's
her
on my
favorite
bad
band.
Aaron's on my bad side.
Happens to be Dave Matthews' band.
Then Aaron's doubling on my bad side.
Now,
because
I'm going to say this
about
Dave. I don't know much of Dave Matthews' catalog, but I will say those first two records, Under the Table and Dreaming, and what was the second one with Crash or whatever, those are good records. Those came out when I was like 10 or 12. And we're seeing them live in February.
Where?
The Embarcadero. It's part of like Super Bowl week.
Oh. That'll be fun.
So I just want you to be, just
and
mind
thus,
your P's and Q's.
Thus, the wedge is driven farther. Between Aaron
we've been waiting a long time for a Yoko, and we thought it was Kevin when Tim brought him into the equation, but it turns out no, it's I guess Nick?
Still might be Kevin.
Yes, please.
In all honesty, still might be Kevin.
True.
But I don't think Kevin's gonna be much of a Yoko. He's gonna be more of a...
Boko.
I don't know, I'm trying to think of like a mass murderer. Maybe like a Charlie Manson?
Sure.
You know, or...
Charlie Manson.
You know what I mean?
Like a Chuck Manson. Oh, Chuck Manson.
Yeah, Chuck Manson.
I went to finishing school with him.
You did. Unfortunately. Did he have the swastika back then, or was it...
No, I'm saying that's a different
name. Was new? Did he kill people back then?
Probably.
When you went to finishing school?
Yeah.
What is a finishing
Have you noticed
school?
How natural and like graceful I am?
You are beautiful. I'll tell you that.
All right, this pizza's getting cold.
Yeah, eat it. No, eat the pizza.
We don't have time, you know, later.
Everything you do...
On what am I gonna have sex with a pizza, Kevin?
No, I'm just reminding you.
Please do, and then support us at patreon.com/kindoffunny.
We're 140 away, right?
From which one?
Oh!
So much to say, so much to say. Sometimes it's easy to be Kevin.
Look at this guy.
We're missing a lot of pizza. I mean, we're missing like they gave us two pepperonis and sausages. They fucked up.
Call them. We're getting free pizza.
Can I get drinks?
Yeah, sure.
This beer, if anyone wants beer.
Oh, I want beer.
Big Daddy IPA.
Yeah, sounds good. Yeah. Good job, James.
No, no cams.
Good job, James. It's actually a really bad job, and I don't like James.
It's okay. He's trying.
I know, but like,
I respect him.
I can still hear everything you're saying, even though you're whispering.
You can't hear. They. You can't. He can't hear.
I like to use these ice cubes. I like when he gets a
little tipsy. They aren't done. You see, the fact that they kind of look like fresh ice.
Yeah. Accidental? No. And the South Koreans felt an earthquake, and that's how they knew.
Well, they assumed it was.
And then the North Koreans.
The epicenter was their. I saw it. Their bomb site.
Yeah.
Past their bong site?
Yeah, bomb.
Kim Jong Un's bomb site is
where
they.
Did you see on the heat map thing?
I only read the AP break. I didn't read anything. About it. So I don't know what the fuck's going on.
Those.
Too bad they have no fucking way of getting it here.
All right, don't test them. They're watching us.
What if Kim Jong-un was a huge fan?
I can't believe they're talking about this. They're talking about me this way.
It probably stoked. Hey, they're talking about me.
What if we set up an interview with him and then...
Do we have Dennis Rodman as well?
Are we making a movie? Yeah, making an interview.
No, I see the joke. I see it.
Greg, way to not recycle it.
Yeah, I did that.
I still like, somebody said, find a yummy for the cooking show. So
really oh, good. Man, that is good. But you know, that's the first time in 30 years I haven't recycled. And it felt great.
I don't like what Kevin does. Tim. He's funnier. Can we just, is there like a, some sort of process where you can talk like a vet and they can cut his tongue out? Or like snip his larynx? You know how like when dogs bark too much, you can actually legitimately kill them? Is that a thing?
You're raging C-U-N-T. See you next Tuesday.
It says see you next Tuesday. What movie is that? It was a trick. It was Thriller. It was the Thriller video.
That burrito is...
Done?
Steaming, my friend.
I think it's everything, honestly.
Is it? Good. Yeah. I hate for my burrito to throw off the flavor profile.
I think the flavor profile... You want to take another... You want to close up with the your finished burrito?
Come on, I'm coming.
But it's burning me! Friends failing me! Ah! You like look at that guy?
Yeah, burst open.
Yeah, I see that. His asshole's got some diarrhea.
Don't you dare wash that pan. I'm going to scrape it off when it gets cold.
Okay. I can do that for you. Or not do that, I guess.
So wait, are you going to glaze the thing now or what?
Let's finish the wing video. Okay. I'll take care of this for you. You'll still see it on Twitch. Because I'm going to plate the shit out of this.
Okay.
The wings are getting put in a bowl. I really enjoy a wing.
All right.
These motherfuckers.
You want to slice?
Not yet. I'm almost there. This has only got less than 2 minutes. But I'm going to show you my cooking acumen, Nick, by making a presentation here. So much to say, so much to say, so much to say. Sometimes it's you want to do the YouTube video with me here real quick? We're about to wrap up here.
Get her done. King Tevin, can you turn the mics off?
These mics. Everybody who's watching on Twitch right now, when this goes up on YouTube, don't fucking narc and say that I was drunk and making burritos at the same time, alright?
Because the beer is not a good enough.
It looks like it's full the entire time. They're like, why'd even pour that beer? This guy should be the next pope.
You're sweating and they see you drinking it.
Here we go.